Assalamu alaikum. Today we will talk about section 6.2, which is about volumes. Our aim in this section is to find the volume of solids. Well, we will start with a simple type of solids called a right cylinder. What do you mean by a right cylinder? That means if you cut everywhere, you get the same shape. For example, here, this is a circular cylinder. If you cut at the middle, you will get a circle. Cut above it, you will get a circle. At the end, you have a circle here, and above here, you have a circle. So all the way, you have a circle. In this case, we call it a right cylinder. Here, in this case, we have the circular cylinder. Why? Because it is a cylinder with circular base. What is the volume of this circular cylinder? Well, it is pi r squared times h. This is a well-known formula. Well, let us look at it carefully. What is pi r squared? Isn't it the area of the cross-section or the area of the base? Yes, so the formula will be A times H. Now let us look at this figure, which is the rectangular box. What is the volume? It will be L times W times the height. Let us cut at the middle. What do we get? We will get a rectangle. See the base, it is a rectangle. See the top, it is again rectangle. So this is again a right cylinder. It is a cylinder with a rectangular base. We said the volume, it is LWH. What is LW? Isn't it the area of the base? So the formula is A times H. Now, see the motivation. And I wrote these details from the textbook. So please read the textbook. He said here, how to find the volume of a solid that is not a cylinder. I mean, if you cut at the middle, you will get a different shape from the end here or at the top. See, for example, figure one, for example. See here, if you cut here, you will get this cross-sectional area, which is the red part here. Is it the same as this? No. Is it the same as this? No. So this is not a cylinder. How can we find the volume of the solid in this case? Step number one, intersect the solid S with a plane to obtain a region that is called a cross section of S. See here, this is the plane. You can see it. If you cut here, assume you have a knife and you cut, what do you get? You get this part, which is called the cross section of S. Next, continue slicing S by dividing S into N slabs of equal width, delta X. As I said, assume you have a knife and please cut here, until you finish cutting this solid. So you will end up with N slabs. Or in other words, if we see this figure here, a similar figure, what shall we do? You need to partition this interval from A to B uniformly with width delta X. So here we get X1, X2, etc. Here we will get xi minus 1, xi, and here this will be bxn. Now, if you cut, you will divide this into n slabs, then what is next? Approximate the volume of the slab si, for example, this one, by the following. It will be the area of the base times the height, as we said before here. What is the base area? It will be A of xi star. Let me write this because this is very important. It will be A of xi star times delta x. This is the base area and this is delta x. Here we said xi star. That means either you can choose right, left, or any sample point in between. Next, add the volume of these slabs to get an approximation to the total volume. That means just add them up. Here you have slab 1, slab 2, etc. Add these slabs. What do you get? You will get approximation of the volume. A of xi delta x, same as this, but put a summation in front of this. I equal to 1 up to n. What is next? As we said before, to make things exact, what shall we do? You need to push the number of these slabs to go to infinity. That means we get step number 5. The approximation becomes bigger and bigger as n goes to infinity. Therefore, we define the volume as the following. V will be the limit of summation I equal to 1 up to infinity A of xi star delta x. Wait. What is this? Isn't it the integral from A to B because we have AB here? A of x dx. And for sure, we need to assume the cross-sectional area A here to be a continuous function. So what is the formula for the volume? It is the integral of the cross-sectional area. Good. Now let us summarize this in the following definition. Definition of the volume. Let S be a solid that lies between x equal to a and x equal to b. If the cross-sectional area of S in the plane be x, through x and perpendicular to the x-axis, let me explain this here. We cut through the x-axis. We use the plane bx. If the cross-sectional area is a of x, where a is a continuous function, as I said, then the volume of S will be V equal limit of summation A of xi star delta x equal the integral from A to B A of x dx. So this is the formula. And notice something here. We cut through the x-axis. What about if we cut this solid over the y-axis? Again, you will have the same formula, but here you will have A of y dy. And at the end of the day, you will get the same volume, provided that you push the number of slabs to go to infinity. Good, this is the definition so far. Now we will start by part number one, solids of revolution. This is clear from the name. These solids are generated by rotating a plane region about a line. That means you have, for example, this region. If you rotate it about the x-axis, you will get a solid. This solid is called a solid of revolution. It comes from where? From rotation or revolution. Now we have two cases. Case A, disk method. In general, we have a case called Awasher method. Now let us see the disk method. If we rotate about a line, a region D that is completely connected, concentrate here, we need to be completely connected to the line of revolution, then the cross sections of the resulting solid will be disks. Let us understand this carefully. You can see it here. This is the region D. If you rotate it, you will get this nice solid. Well, let me do it again for you. Assume we need to rotate this region D. Concentrate here. If you rotate this region in two dimensions, you will get a solid in three dimensions. First, look here. This region is completely connected to the line of revolution. I mean, there is no gap here. You need to copy a mirror, and you may connect this line. You know this, if you rotate a line, you will get a circle. I repeat, this is very important in this section. Think about it this way. Assume you have this bin, fix it at the end. If you rotate it, what do you get? Just look here. Just rotate it, you will get a circle. If we fix this bin, you will get what? You will get the circle. So if you rotate this line at the end, you will get this nice circle. Alright, let us go to the two-dimensional shape just to give you something. If we draw a perpendicular rectangle to the line of revolution, if you rotate this rectangle, what do you get? Yes, you will get a circle, but we will call it a disk. See here, please. Do you see this rectangle? If you rotate it, you will get this shape. This is the cap of a bottle, for example. Do you see this part? This part will come from the rectangle. So if I draw it here, I will get this shape. Now, if you remove this, assume you have it here, and you remove it, what do you get? You will get this shape. This is a disk, and this is the thickness of that disk. So I will say in this case, this is the disk. It is a filled circle with radius r. We call it a disk. Is it clear? You can see these details in my notes. And as I said, this is the thickness. This is the thickness comes from this cap of the bottle. In this case, the volume will be what? The integral of A of x. What is the area? The area, not the area of this two-dimensional part. It is the area of the disk here, which is the area of a circle, which is pi r squared. So in the disk method, the formula will be just integrate by r squared, either dx or dy. Here we integrate respect to x because we cut through the x-axis. If we cut through the y-axis, the formula will be dy. You will see this in the examples. This is the typical question in the exam and in the textbook. He said, find the volume of the solid obtained by rotating about the x-axis, the region D under the curve y equal root x from 0 to 1. Well, we have four steps. Let us say them quickly. First, you need to draw the region. You need to draw a rectangle perpendicular to the line of revolution. You will get a cross section. Find the area of the cross section. Then integrate the area of the cross section. That's it. This is the method. But let us work out this example slowly. Draw the region. This is our root x. He said from 0 to 1, this is 0 and this is 1.
What is next? We need to draw a rectangle that is perpendicular to the line of revolution, which is the x-axis over here.
But this is the perpendicular rectangle. Now, see, this rectangle will give you the disk. Let us repeat it again here. Give me a mirror of that. As we said, if you rotate a line, you will get the circle over here. I mean the line at the end. If you rotate this rectangle, you will get this disk. So I will draw it this way. Allow me to write it here, disk with a radius r. It is a filled circle. Let me fill it. Now, as I said, draw a rectangle to the line of revolution. In this case, it is the x-axis. The cross-section is a disk in this case. Why? Because the rectangle or the region is completely connected to the line of revolution. I mean, there is no gap. This disk has the following. It has a thickness. What is the thickness? It is delta x. You see it. We cut through the x-axis. Or simply, the rectangle is sitting on the x-axis. In fact, delta x, as we said, it is xi minus xi minus 1. Now, what is the radius of this disk? R equal what? See here, the radius comes from where? See it maybe here. This is the radius R, right? Or you can see it here. The radius will come from here, from the height of the rectangle. It is top, y at the top minus y at the bottom. What is that? It will be root x minus 0. You will get root x. Now the question is over. Let us go to step 3. Find the area of the cross section. In this case, the area of the cross section is a of x. And what is the formula? It is pi r square. It is pi times root. You will get pi x. Step 4 says, find the limits of integration and integrate a of x. So the volume simply will be the integral of a of x, as we said. It is pi r square dx. From where to where? X runs from 0 to 1, so integrate from 0 to 1, please. It will be the integral from 0 to 1 by x. Dx, this is very simple integral, by x squared over 2, evaluated from
0 to 1, substitute, you will get the final answer to be pi over 2. Now we will see this video together. We see this figure. This is y equal root x. Now we rotate it. We get the resulting solid. Again, we rotate it. Now, if you cut at the middle, you will get a disk. You will see it now. You see this disk over here? The distance from here to here is x. And the thickness will be delta x. I mean, in the integration, we will have dx. This is very important to visualize things. And r here, as I said, it will be root x minus 0, to be more precise. Root x minus 0, y at the bottom. Now, this is another situation. If we rotate about the y-axis, see here. This is the resulting solid. The distance from here to here is y. And clearly, the thickness is delta y. R will be what? We will do this today. X equal what in the right minus X equal to what in the left. You will understand these details.
Any question here, Shabab? In the integration, it means you integrate respect to X. Also, here in the resulting solid, it means the thickness. It's like the height. It is the height of this disk. Question 2. He said, find the volume of the solid obtained by rotating the region bounded by y equal x cubed, y equal to 8, and x equal to 0 about the y-axis. Step number 1, draw the region. Y equal x cubed is something like this. Now, let us close it by y equal to 8 here. And he said, x equal to 0, so we close it over here. So this is the region that we need to rotate. Step number 2, draw a rectangle perpendicular to the line of revolution. In this case, it is y-axis. So let us draw it over here. Just to understand the full picture, let us draw it here. Let us copy a mirror. Let us close it.
Here we get a circle.
Now, if you rotate this rectangle, what do you get? You will get this disk. Now, do you see this? If you take it away, you will get a disk. So allow me to say here, disk. And why do we get this, Keshbab? This is very important. The region is completely connected to the line of revolution. Just to see, this is our delta y, which is the thickness. Now, if we draw the rectangle, so the cross section will be a disk with the following. What is the thickness? As I said here, it is delta y because we are cutting over the y-axis. And what is the radius r? See here, the distance from here to here is your r. Right? If you cannot see this clearly, let us see it over here. Remember this note again. When we subtract vertical distance, you will say y top minus y bottom. But if you subtract horizontally like this, you need to ask this question. X right equal to what? And x left equal to what? This is very important. Now we are subtracting horizontally. Then you need to tell me x here and x here. Remember, this is y equal x cube. Great. What is x? If you solve, you get y to the power 1 over 3. Is it clear? So the radius r will be y to the power 1 over 3. This is x right. Minus what is x over here? This is clearly xl. I will call it x left, which is 0. So the final answer will be y to the power 1 over 3. Find the area of the cross section. It is a of y. Everything depends on y now. As we said, it depends on the thickness. A of y is equal what? By r squared. It is the same story as we did in the previous example. Plug r here, you will get by y to the power 2 over 3. Now, step number 4, find the limits of integration and integrate this a of y. You will get v equal, I repeat, integral of a of y, so that you memorize the formula. dy. What is a of y? It is by r square. And what is r square in this case? It is y to the power 2 over 3 dy. Answer me in the chat now. I need to integrate from where to where. Quickly, please. Thank you very much. From 0 to a. This is very important. Since we integrate with respect to y, you need to read over here. From 0 to 8 or from here, from 0 to 8. But it will be easy for you to read from here. So integrate from 0 to 8. By integrate this, you will get 5 over 3. I am adding 1 into the exponent. And multiply by 3 over 5. Evaluate from 0 to 8. If you plug 8 here, you will get 8 to the power 1 over 3, that is 2, to the power 5, 32. If you simplify, believe me, you will get this number, 96 over 5 by. I repeat, the volume of this resulting solid is equal 96 over 5 by. Now, I will give you a very nice note. It will be helpful. In the exam, it is not necessary to draw the resulting solid over here. Here it is easy because we are in the disk case. Once we are in the washer method, things will get complicated. So I can answer this question with looking here. But I draw the solid for you so that you understand the full picture. Now let us see the general case. In general, we have something called a washer method. What do you mean by a washer? A washer means circle inside circle, but it has a thickness. This is called a washer. Just to give you a real example, see over here. I have something very nice here. This is a washer. It has two radii, small radius, we call it inner radius, and we have outer radius, big one. For sure, you have a thickness over here. So this is called a washer. He said here, if the region D is not completely connected to the line of revolution, I mean, there is a gap or there is an empty space between the region D and the line of revolution, then the cross-section will be washers. Let us understand this carefully. Do you see this region over here? Is this region, this blue region, is it connected to the line of revolution? No. There is a gap or an empty space. See it over here. So if you rotate it, you will get this resulting solid. I hope it's clear. If it's not clear, let me draw the picture for you. This is the washer. Assume this is our region D. We need to rotate it about this line. As we said, what do we need to do? We need to draw a rectangle perpendicular to the line of revolution. Let me draw it over here. And for sure, give me a mirror. Draw this rectangle. Now, concentrate, please. If you rotate this, you will get two circles. One circle will come from here. And another one will come from the farthest distance over here. Where is the washer? This is the washer. I I repeat, this is the washer. Let's draw it again. It is a circle and you have a small circle. For sure you have a radius. I will call it small r. This is the inner radius. And we have a capital R. What is that? R equal R out, the outer radius. And small r is equal the inner Rn, which is the inner radius. Is this clear, Shabab? You have two radii. Now, if somebody asks you how to find R out and R in, it's very clear from this figure. But can you give me a definition so that we can use it in later examples? Well, yes. Assume you are here, sitting on this line. I know my drawing is bad. What is your small r? Well, you will say my small r is this, or comes from this blue circle. What is the definition? It is the distance from the line of revolution up to the nearest curve. See here, you are sitting on this line and you are looking this way. What is your nearest curve? It is this one. So the distance from the line of revolution up to the nearest will give you small r. While the distance from the line of revolution again up to the farthest curve will give you r out. Let me write it for you. The distance from here to here will give you capital R. While the distance from here to here will give you small r. So as I said, this is the resulting solid. And you can see the washer. See here, I draw the rectangle here and here. And I get this washer and it is over here. And what do we need from the washer or from the disk? We need to integrate the cross-sectional area. What is the cross-sectional area of this washer? Clearly it is pi r square, the area of the large circle, minus pi r square, which is the area of the small circle. Just integrate this and that's it. So what is the formula for the washer? It is the integral of pi r square minus pi small r square dx or dy. It depends on how we cut, over the x-axis or the y-axis. Now I will share my entire screen. Here we have y equal root x. Now we will draw y equal 1 over 10x. It is a line. You will see it now. Now we will close this region by x equal to 4. All right. Do you see this orange region? Now we need to rotate this region about the x-axis. For sure, you will see the water. Let us see together. See from this side, please. Do you see the washer? It is coming. It is very nice washer. Now let us cut it from the middle. Can we see the washer? Yes, it is here. It is very interesting. Let us repeat this. Do you see the orange region here? Now we will rotate it. It is very important to visualize this. Now if you cut it, what do you get? You will get the washer. Clear? The washer, for sure, it has two radii, the radius of the smaller one and the radius of the larger one. This is very important. In fact, we are integrating the area of this typical washer. Be careful, we are not integrating the orange region over here. Be careful, usually the students miss this. Now let us see question number 3. He said, find the volume of the solid obtained by rotating the region D enclosed by the curves y equal to x and y equal x squared. Well, we will start rotating this about the x-axis. See here this paper. We will rotate it about the x-axis. Then we will rotate about y equal to 2. Then y equal to minus 3. See these. These are horizontal lines, right? Then we will rotate about x equal to minus 1, x equal to 4. These are vertical lines. And for sure, if you change the line of revolution, you will get different radii and hence you will get different volumes. This is very important and this is the reason for choosing this specific exercise. Now let us see these steps. The first step, as usual, we need to draw the region and we need to find the intersection points. We draw the region. This is y equal to x. This is not difficult. It passes through 0, 0 and 1, 1, for example. Now let us draw x squared. It is a parabola like this. Good. Now we need to find intersection points. This is one of them and this is one of them. Well, we need to solve y equal to x and y equal x squared. As we said before, y equal to y, then for sure the right hand side will be equal. So we need to solve x equal x squared. And for sure, x will be equal to 0 or x equal to 1. If you didn't see this, let me do it for you quickly. Put everything on the left hand side, you will get x squared minus x equal to 0. factor x, please, you will get x minus 1 equal to 0. Solve this equation, we will get x equal to 0 or x equal to 1, as we said. This will be 0, what? Substitute here or here. This is 0, 0. And this is 1, what? Substitute here or here, you will get 1, 1. Alright, this is y equal x square, and this is y equal to x. Step number 2, draw a rectangle perpendicular to the line of revolution. Here, what is it? It is the x-axis. So let me fill the gaps. We need to draw a perpendicular rectangle like this. Draw it in your region only. Great. Now, you see that I draw two figures here. This will be the region D, and for sure it is this enclosed region. Good. And here I will draw for you the typical one. This is our figure over here. You need to copy a mirror here. A mirror, be careful. Do not copy paste. So this will be like this. This is increasing. Then this one will be decreasing like this. And also, do not forget to draw the rectangle here and here. As we said, you need to connect this point with this point. I mean, the nearest part with the nearest part. Let us do it carefully. This is one circle, and from here to here, you can draw another big circle. All right, do you see the washer itself? It's not accurate enough, but you see it. You see a circle inside circle. So if you rotate this rectangle, it will fill the washer. As we said, if we draw a rectangle perpendicular to the x-axis, hence the cross-section will be a washer. Well, you can see it clearly over here, or you can see it also from here. Why? Because there is a gap. I mean, the region or the rectangle is not connected completely to the line of revolution, which is x-axis. I will draw an arrow like this. This washer has a thickness. What is the thickness? Clearly, it will be what? Delta x? The interval over here, it is delta x, good. Or you can say if we expand this rectangle, it will sit in the x-axis. So it will be delta x. Now, what is the outer radius, capital R, and what is the inner radius, small r? Well, you can see it from here or here. What is the outer radius?
It is the distance from the line of revolution up to the nearest curve.
Let's see it over here. The distance from this line of revolution up to here will be my little r. The capital R, it will be again from the line of revolution up to the farthest curve. Do you see it? What is the farthest curve? It is x here. So this will be my capital R. It is very important. Let us see this paper. When we subtract vertically like this, R and R, you need to tell me y top and y bottom. Good. What is capital R? You can see it from here. It is x minus. What is y at the bottom here? It is 0. So I will write x minus 0, which is x. Now, what is my little r? Read these from here. What is y at the top? It is x squared. Do you see it? Minus, what is my y at the bottom? It is 0, so it will be x squared. Step number 3. We need to find the area of the cross-section, and we will integrate it to get the volume. This is the definition, right? So as we said, integrate the cross-sectional area, which is a of x in this case, dx. Why did I write dx? D is very important. It will come from the thickness. The thickness will help you to know the variable of integration. And for sure, I will integrate from 0 to 1, because remember, dx means the x value runs from 0 up to, what is this?
It is 1.
Now, what is the area of the washer? It will be by, you remember this? R square minus by little r square dx. Just plug this and that's it. Again, it's from 0 to 1. Let us take by common factor. To simplify my calculation, I will do it this way. All square minus something square. Do you see it? I will plug r here and little r here. What is capital R? It was x, so I will write x here. What is my little r? It is x squared. See it over here. So that's it. This is a simple integral. Let me do it directly. This is just for fun. X squared, if you integrate it, you will get x cubed over 3 minus. This is x to the power 4. If you integrate it, you will get x to the power 5 over 5 from 0 to 1. If you evaluate, you will get what? 1 over 3 minus 1 over 5. If you plug 0, you will get 0. I think this is not difficult. If you simplify here, you will get 5 minus 3, that is 2 over 15, and do not forget the by. So this is the answer. We solved the question fully. I know we took more time, but in the next coming exercise, we will not take this time. From next time, we will not draw the typical washer. We will directly draw here, and we will find R and R, and that's it. Any question here?
Yes, you can solve, but at the same time, I want you to know how to draw the washer.
This is very important. If you understand how to do it, you can understand the course fully. If you draw it like this, where is the washer? It seems that there is nothing clear here. At least do it for one example. For the others, it's fine. This is very important. We said this If you have delta x, then in integration you will have dx. Clear? And once you have the integration dx, you need to evaluate from the smallest x up to the largest x. And also, you need to solve the equation for y. Here it is already given for you. It is y equal. But if it is given the other way around, we need to solve for y first. Good. Here you may write this. Solve always for the other variable. In the previous exercise, we had what? We had the x-axis, which was what? Below the region. Now see, I will give you a line which is above the region. In the next exercise, I will give you what? One on the right and one on the left to see the situation. He said about the line y equals to 2. Everything is the same. So this is my y equal x squared and this is y equal to 2. All right, what are the steps? You need to draw a perpendicular rectangle. Let me draw it here for you. From here, what can you say about the cross section? It will be a measure because there is an empty space between the rectangle and the line of revolution. See here, if you rotate this over here, you will get two circles. There is an empty space. Good, so we will get the washer. So I will write it is a washer. It has a thickness. What is the thickness? It is delta x because we are cutting over the x-axis. What is my capital R and what is my little r? I will give you something and you will not forget it. Assume you are here. You are sitting on this line. I am bad at drawing. Now tell me, what is your nearest curve? Is it x or y equal x squared? It is x. So I will draw a line from here up to here. This will be my little r. Go to the line of revolution and come down until you reach the farthest curve. This is your capital R. As we said before, do you remember y top minus y bottom? So my capital R, it will be 2 minus y here, which is x squared. So I will write 2 minus x squared. What is my little r? It will be 2 minus, what is the nearest? It is y equal to x. Maybe you forget this. So it will be 2 minus x. And the thickness is delta x. Not something. If you have delta x, then everything should be in terms of x. And what is the volume in this case? Be by r squared minus by little r all squared dx, since the variable integration is x. From where to where? This is 0 and this is 1. It is the same exercise. We do not need to repeat these things. Not something. What is this? This is the area in terms of x. Take by confact, for example. Then I am left with this bracket. Do you remember this? Something squared minus something squared dx. I will put r here, which is 2 minus x squared. All right, and I will put here little r, which is 2 minus x. That's it. Do this integral at home, and believe me, you will get the answer 8 pi over 15. You need to take 2 minutes to solve this exercise. All right, time is up. Let us start solving. And you can count the time for me. I will not take more than 2 minutes. He said here about the line y equal to minus 3. It is something here. Now, first step, you need to draw a rectangle perpendicular to the line of revolution. Now, if you rotate this rectangle, what do you get? For sure, you will get a washer because there is an empty space. So we get a washer with the following. What is the thickness? Again, if you expand this, this rectangle will sit in the x-axis. And for sure, the thickness will be delta x. And what is capital R? What is little r? As we said before, start from the line of revolution until you reach the nearest curve. This is your little r. And again, start from here. Do you remember this man? From the line of revolution up to the farthest curve, this is your capital R. What is your capital R? Let us read it together. It is x minus this minus 3. And if you simplify this, you will get x plus 3. Now let us see little r. It will be y top minus y bottom. That is x squared minus, what is this here? It is minus 3. So the answer will be x squared plus 3. That's it. The integral will be by r squared minus little r all squared dx, as we said, because we have delta x. From where to where? From 0 to 1, because we already said this many times. This will be by integral square minus something square, and you have something dx. What is capital R? It is x plus 3. What is little r? Just copy and paste it. X squared plus 3 from 0 to 1, and that's it. I think I took maybe less than 2 minutes. Here I have a quick note. This is our delta x. This is the thickness of the washer. He said r and r are fixed somehow. Here r with what? With x. Capital R. Right? C capital R. With x squared. So if you do not draw, then that's it. Game is over for you. He said do the same, but rotate the region about the line of x equal to minus 1. Now see the line of revolution on the left of our region. Right? First step, you need to draw the rectangle perpendicular to the line of revolution. You see it over here. There is a gap here. So the thickness will be what? Be careful, the thickness will be changing now. It will be delta y, because the interval on the y-axis, if you expand this, then the interval will be on the y-axis. So it will be delta y. Now let us see capital R and small r. Do you remember this little man? From this little man up to the nearest curve will be little r. And again, from the man up to the farthest curve, this will be capital R. Here we have a very, very important thing. Usually the student, when they subtract, they will say x squared minus minus 1. This is a mistake. Let us recall this nice paper. When you subtract horizontally like this, you need to ask this question. What is x right and what is x left? Or we said this before, if you have delta y, then you need to solve for x. This is y equal x squared. But if you solve for x, you will get x equal root y. We need to use this. This is very important. And what is this? Y equal to x. Solve for x, you will get x equal to y. Now subtract, please. So what is my capital R? Let us read. It will be root y minus this guy, which is minus 1. I repeat myself. Capital R will be from here to here. What is x here? Read x. I mean the right hand side. It will be root y. Minus, what is this? It is minus 1. Now let us find little r. It is from here up to here. What is my x over here? Read the right hand side, it is y. Minus. What is x on the left? Clearly it is minus 1. That's it. So what is the volume? By integral r square minus r square dy or dx. This is very important. Do you see the benefit of the thickness? You need to integrate respect to y. I will integrate from 0 to 1. Be careful. You need to integrate from this 0 on the y-axis up to the number 1 in the y-axis. This is bracket square. This is bracket square dy. What is capital R? You know this. This is root y plus 1. Now what is little r? It is y plus 1. And if you evaluate this at home, it will be pi over 2. Maybe I forget this. This is awasher. Now please try part E. Take 2 minutes. All right, time is up. He said you need to rotate this about the line x equal to 4. And notice this. The line x equal to 4 on the right of our region. So things will be changing. As we said, first step, you need to draw a perpendicular rectangle to the line of revolution. Done. So if you rotate this, what do you get? You will get a washer because there is an empty space. So I will write washer. What is the thickness of this washer? We said this, it is similar to the previous bars. It will be delta y. If you need to see this delta y, see it over here. We need capital R and small r. See here, again, start from the line of revolution up to the farthest curve. This will be your capital R. And again, from the line of revolution up to the nearest curve, this will be little r. Is it clear? And remember, when we say delta y, you need to solve for x, because you will subtract x right minus x left. You remember, already we said this. This is x equal root y, right? And what is this? We already said this is x equal to y. So what is my capital R? Read, please. It is 4 minus, read the right hand side, it is y. So it is 4 minus y. And what is my little r? Again, it is 4 minus, what is x on the left here? It is 4 minus root y. So the volume will be by integral r square minus little r square dy. Remember, we have delta y, so we have an integration dy. Again, it is from 0 to 1, similar to the previous exercise. So the integral will be something square minus something square. Put r here, which is 4 minus y. And put small r here, 4 minus root y, all dy. And evaluate this at home. The final answer will be 7 pi over 6. It's not difficult, but I do not want to waste my time. Here I have some notes. Do you see the arrow here? This arrow means that x equal to 4 is the line of rotation. When I see your answers in the chat, some of you didn't get R correctly. They said Y minus 4. Be careful. It is a mistake. When you subtract X right and X left, you need to subtract X right minus X left. You need to subtract the largest minus the smallest. We said this, I mean, in the section of 6.1. So this is the right and this is the left. Well, one student will say it will not matter because we have power 2 here. Yes, you are right, but assume in the exam we said no, we need capital R and small r. You will not get it, so be careful. All right, here I have a quick note. Here I said x equal root y. Why did I not say x equal plus or minus? See here, please. Do you see this parabola? This part is the plus the root, and this part negative the root. Just to clarify, this is y equal x squared. If you solve for x, you will get x equal plus or minus root y. So this part will be x equal root y, and this part will be negative root y. How can you check this? Read please here. X equal what? Plus the root. This is positive, right? That means x is positive. The positive values of x are here. Similarly here, where are the negative values of x? They are over here. Is this clear? This is very important to know. And let us recall this exercise. You remember x equal y square. Alright, this is not a function. Now let us solve for y. You will get y equal plus or minus root x. The upper part will be y equal root x, and the lower part will be y equal minus root x. And this makes sense. Y equal plus the root. That means y is positive. And you can see this. Y is positive over here. Now let us summarize the steps. Summary of steps in disk or washer methods. First step, you need to draw the region and you need to find the intersection points. Easy. Next step, draw a rectangle perpendicular to the line of revolution. This is very important in this section. In the next coming section, 6.3, we need to draw a parallel rectangle. This is very important to know. Now, if you draw this rectangle, determine the tie of the cross-sections, whether it is a disk or a washer. We said this, if you have a gap, then it will be a washer. If there is no gap, then it will be a disk. After you find the disk or the washer, determine the thickness and the radius or the radii. Now, the thickness will be delta x if the line of revolution is horizontal, and it will be delta y if the line of revolution is vertical. If you need to memorize this, memorize it. But for myself, I do not memorize this. Well, for two reasons. The first reason is that you will have lots of things in this course. So please do not memorize anything in the course. This is one thing. The next thing, in the next section, we will have the other way around. If the line of revolution is vertical, then you will get delta x. It will be the other way around. So I know it this way. Assume you have a function like this. Alright, and we say the line of revolution is horizontal. For example, the x-axis. Just draw a perpendicular rectangle. What is the thickness? Clearly, it is delta x. The rectangle is sitting on the x-axis. Let us double check. Horizontal, delta x. There is nothing to memorize. Now, what is the definition of the outer radius and the inner radius? As we said, the outer radius will be the distance from the line of revolution up to the farthest curve, while the inner radius will be the distance from the line of revolution up to the nearest curve. And be careful, you need to subtract y top minus y bottom or x right minus x left. All right, after I find the thickness and the radii, this is the most important step. Just go directly to step 5, which is find the cross-sectional area A of x or A of y. It depends on the thickness. If the cross-section is a disk, then the area will be pi r squared. While if the cross-section is a washer, then the area will be pi r squared minus pi little r squared. All right. What is the next step? Just integrate the cross-sectional area. Sometimes I mix step 5 and 6 together. I say integrate the area. What is the area? Whether it is this or this. So it will be the integral of a of x dx or a of y dy. Again, it depends on the line of revolution, whether it is delta y or dx. Good. Now let us see this table. It is a summary of everything. In the disk method, you integrate by r square either dx or dy. Dx, if you have line of revolution, is horizontal. And it will be delta y if you have vertical line of revolution. And in general, we have the washer method. It is the same stuff. Instead of pi r square, we will have pi capital R square minus pi little r square dx. Dx in this case, and it will be delta y or dy if you have vertical line of revolution. Okay, this is the summary of the first part in this section. Question 4. He said, find the volume of the solid obtained by rotating the region bounded y equal root x, y equal to 0, and x equal to 4 about the line y equal to 5. In the next example, we will change the line of revolution to see what are the changes. Well, first of all, let us draw the region. This is y equal root x. And he said, close it by y equal to 0, which is the x-axis, and close it by the vertical line x equal to 4. Well, as we said, this is 4. What is the point? It is 4, what? The y value is given here. Substitute. You will get 4.2. Good. What is the next step? You need to draw the rotation line, which is y equal to 5. Let's draw it over here. All right. Next, let us draw a perpendicular rectangle to the line of revolution. Here it is. Now, if you rotate this part, for sure you will get a washer because there is an empty space. So to find this washer, what shall we do? Remember this little man. The distance from this little man, which is the line of revolution, up to the nearest curve will be your little r. While the distance from the line of revolution up to the farthest curve will be your capital R. All right. As we said, the cross section is a washer, which has the following thickness. What is the thickness? Here it is clear delta x, because the interval here it is on the x-axis. What is capital R? You need to subtract this way. Top, y top minus y bottom. That is 5 minus 0. So we get 5. Now let us see the little r. What is it? Y top here minus y bottom here. It will be 5 minus, what is this? It is root x. Now, what is the volume? Using the formula, it will be pi r squared minus little r squared d what? Dx, because the thickness is delta x. From where to where? I will integrate from 0 to 4. Be careful, I need to integrate from the smallest x up to the largest x in the region, which is 4. That's it. Just plug things and that's it. What is r squared? It is 5 all square minus another bracket all square. Here I will write 5 minus root x dx. All right, time is up. Let us solve this exercise together. Well, first of all, this is our region. We draw it already. Now let us draw a perpendicular rectangle to the line of revolution, which is the y-axis over here. For sure we get a washer because there is an empty space. You can see it over here. What is the thickness? It is delta y. And since we have delta y, don't forget we need to solve for x. This is very important. What is my little r? It will be the distance from here up to the nearest curve. So this is my little r. Now let us see capital R. Up to here, x. On the right, it is x equal to 4. What is x on the left? You can see it is 0. So I will say 4 minus 0, which is 4. Now let us see little r. This one is very interesting. It will be x right here minus x left here. What is x here on the curve? We had y equal root x, right? Now what is your x? Clearly x will be y square. So I will say y square minus 0, which is y square. That's it. From where to where I need to integrate? I need to integrate from 0 up to what is the largest y value here. It is 2. So you see the differences? By integral, what is my capital R? It is 4 square minus, what is my little r? It is y square, all square, dy. And that's it. Evaluate this at home. You will get this number. 128 pi over 5. All right. Now, let us finish the recording with this nice exercise. I will not solve it. You need to solve it. Maybe I will give you a hint. This exercise is the same exercise. He said, what about if we rotate it about the x-axis? Well, the answer is 8 pi. But what do you think? About the x-axis, it is over here. The region over here is completely connected. So you will get a disk. This is the end of the first part of section 6.2. Thank you very much.